Hello everyone, Angel here, and again with my second recording of the evening, combined with the three episodes I did 2 days ago now. I've now done 5 episodes in the last week, which is incredible progress for me. Hopefully we'll be at the end of this, coming to the end of this campaign soon, so I can get to doing the mods and hopefully get some better gameplay out of those. But for now, we're going to continue. We're on episode 7, mission 3. We just had an alliance with the Romulans and the Klingons to combat the Cardassian Kesok threat. And now we're going to see how they're managing to supply their fleets so readily. Though I still have the question, okay, let's just for the sake of argument assume you have a nice shipyard capacity. How are you manning the ships? You have to have trained personnel to man the ships, presumably. So maybe the game's going to say, oh, they're automated somehow. You know, the advanced technology requires less crew. Therefore, you can just churn out the ships as much as you want and not worry about the crew. That at least would make sense. So yeah, let's move forward. That is a new music track, I think. I noticed it in the last episode.
Incoming message from Admiral Liu.
Captain, for some time, Starfleet has been preparing a series of offensive strikes aimed at reclaiming the Alioth system and the rest of the Federation territory that the Cardassians have taken. With our victory here at Starbase 12, it is time to put that plan into action. Starfleet Intelligence has located a number of Cardassian sensor posts situated along the battlefront. We have confirmation the 4 main sensor posts are located in the Poseidon, Artrus, Gebel, and Ceres systems. These stations are able to monitor our movements and serve as an advance warning system. Any incursion into Cardassian-controlled space would be detected by these stations and readily intercepted. Therefore, it is imperative these sensor posts be destroyed before we conduct an offensive. Additionally, Starfleet Intelligence has located a Cardassian resupply outpost in the Acela system. It provides support for the majority of Cardassian forces protecting the Alioth crash site. If we are to retake the system and rescue Commander Data, this station must be neutralized. When these objectives have been achieved, contact me for further instructions. Good luck, Captain. Liu out.
Okay.
If we destroy the sensor posts first, we'd have better odds of taking the resupply outpost by surprise.
Okay, so I was literally about to ask this question. What do we go for first? My inclination was actually outpost first, and then the sensors, but again, I guess that makes sense. So, we'll do that. First, though, we need a reload. So, let's dock.
Docking sequence initiated.
I imagine how this will go down. We'll get the sensor posts. One or two might be undefended and easily to kill. Then we'll have to obviously fight some Cardassian ships along the way. Maybe we'll get a bit of help. I'm sure we'll see the Geronimo and the Enterprise again. There's also the Kittimer.
Hello, Sovereign.
And the San Francisco. Okie doke. It was the Acela system, wasn't it, with the outpost.
Your orders, Captain?
Yes, Acela. Okay, right. There we go, pressing escape again. Close. Cancel.
Yes, sir?
Set a course for... Let's go for Ceres first. Course, let's go in. Backwards.
Yes, Captain.
Okay, there's that new music track. I think that popped in and started popping in an episode or so ago.
3 Galore class vessels circling the sensor station.
Red alert, shields up.
Well, we don't need to engage the Cardassians necessarily. We can just take out the sensor post, right, and then fuck off. So let's do that. Let's put shields max. go engines hot as well.
We're in danger of colliding with another ship, Captain.
That's fine. This thing does not seem to have shields. Does it have... Oh, let's just target the power plant. Let's go low intensity phases.
Port shield draining, Captain.
Let's roll over then. I don't think it really matters, does it?
Integrity at 75%.
Sir, another ship is on a collision course with us.
Okay, our port shields need to be covered a little bit here.
Captain, their attacks are draining our starboard shield.
There we go. Right, let's get out of here.
The sensor station has been destroyed.
We're in danger of colliding with another ship, Captain. Course laid in. Yes, Captain.
Yep, I'm gonna go straight back to Starbase 12. Rearm, repair, re-energize. This is quite a cheesy way to do it, but the fact that the game allows me to do it is like, well, fine, I'm just totally gonna abuse that then.
Captain, those ships have followed us from the last system.
Should we try to shake them?
Sovereign to Starbase 12. We're being tailed by multiple hostiles. We hope to make a stand here.
Oh, well, interesting.
Sovereign dragged in. If you lead them to us, Captain, we should be able to take some of the pressure off you.
Captain, I'm picking up a Federation distress call on all frequencies. It's the Geronimo.
To all Starfleet are at 75%. We've been ambushed in the Zion trading system and need immediate assistance. Our ship is meeting heavy resistance from Cardassian and Kessock ships. Please assist.
Okay, so we'll need to help him, but first off, I'm actually genuinely impressed that the ships came here and they had a script for it that we could actually use this to our advantage. So whilst, yes, it's still a bit of a cheesy thing that I'm doing, the fact that they added some narrative bonus here is a bonus. I mean, yeah, it's a narrative bonus, so of course it's a bonus. It's a dumb thing to say. It's like the Starbase phaser is, like, wider than mine.
Integrity at 20%.
One torpedo should finish you off. No, well, one phaser.
Hull is severely damaged,
sir. We're in danger of colliding with another ship, Captain.
Shields are at 75%.
Our
power system has been disabled, sir.
Oh, God. Can we dock? No, we can't.
What? You destroy these hostiles, and then I'll let you dock.
That's brilliant. Where's the starbase? We're going to need to use the starbase as a shield here. Oh, can I warp away?
75%.
Because I might actually die here. I might legitimately die here. I mean, look at my health. Need to roll my shields around. Let's go this way up. So, power grid, you say. So we've lost a forward tractive, aft torpedo, warp core. Let's try and keep our shields strong. So basically, I'm just going to angle away here and hopefully use the starbase's sheer mass to simply cheese this a little. And hope that the Geronimo is not going to be in any danger whilst it's not actually being rendered on a screen and there's no maths or calculations or timers hidden to prevent that. Right, where are the gallows? Shield
has failed, Captain.
So that one's still trying to come after me. Let's stay here.
Target hull integrity at 75%.
We are going to need some more torpedoes back, please. All right. Shields brimming back up a bit. This galore is coming down, so I'm going to move now towards and intercept. Let's bring our sensors. Engines. Oh, we can't. Our power systems are still a bit fucked. That's fine. Well. Yes, nice.
The RAF shield has failed, Captain.
Oh, my upper phaser strips are down as well. Are they destroyed? No.
We are their top shield.
Audio only.
All hands abandon ship! All hands on!
Oh no. Okay. You know what? I'm not really.
The Geronimo has been destroyed.
Damn.
I feel bad in that I don't feel bad.
The forward shield is draining.
But I'm also
sent us a message.
Wondering.
I'm afraid I have bad news. As of 1800 hours today, the USS Geronimo
their top
was
shield
lost
has failed.
All hands. Upon completion of her patrol, she was to be assigned to your task force. I know
target
Captain
hull
McGraves
integrity
will be
at 20%.
He and his crew will be missed. Your orders remain the same. Continue your assignment and report back to me when it is accomplished.
The RAF shield has failed, Captain.
You know, they've made such a big deal about that in the game that makes me strongly suspect that we kind of need the Geronimo to survive for it to continue onwards. So I'm actually going to replay this and do a better job. We're not too deep into this, so I think I'll just replay it and see how we're going on. I do think my strategy of killing the sensor outpost made sense.
Incoming message from Admiral Liu.
Captain, for some time Starfleet has been preparing a series of offensive strikes.
But yeah, I got fucked over there by having half my systems knocked out.
If we destroy the sensor posts first, we'd have better odds of taking the resupply outpost by surprise.
Welcome back.
So yeah, well, I'll try the same approach, but maybe you just go to a different system first. I don't know. Or maybe no, we'll just try the same approach. Let's see what happens. So how are we doing? That's fine. Right, we're going to red alert now.
Shields up.
Set a course for Ceres. And we'll put weapons and engines at max. And shields as well, why not? Warp.
Captain, I'm reading three Galore class vessels circling the sensor station.
Right, let's kill the sensor outpost. We'll target the power plant directly. We'll go low intensity phases. You know what? Regular torpedoes are fine right now. But I am going to switch back to quantums, get that initial volley off. So it looks like targeting the power plant will be quicker than just targeting the whole outpost. Hoping torpedoes would load by now, come on. Oh, that's nice. That's a lot of damage I just avoided. Come on. It's offline now. Not enough.
Integrity at 75%.
Sir, another ship is on a collision course with us.
Well, move out of the way then.
set course Starbase 12, warp.
Station has been destroyed, sir.
Can we dock before they arrive? Let's find out. I just heard them warp as we left. Can we dock? Can we dock?
Docking sequence?
Yes, we can dock.
Should we try to shake them? Sovereign to Starbase 12. We're being tailed by multiple hostiles. We hope to make a stand here.
Jeez, the game.
Well, look what the Sovereign dragged in. If you lead them to us, Captain, we should be able to take some of the pressure off you. Welcome back.
Brilliant. Right. Now we're at full power. Let's take them down.
Their bottom shield is draining, sir.
Yeah, if we got the station helping us as well, this should make things a little easier.
Captain, I'm picking up a Federation distress call on all systems. It's the Geronimo.
At least we know now that that is on a timer.
Trading system and need immediate assistance.
Their top shield
has failed.
Our ship
is meeting heavy resistance from Cardassian and Kessok ships. Please assist.
Target hull integrity at 75%. Their aft shield has failed, Captain. Target hull integrity at 20%.
Good. Let's try and take this one down. And then I wonder if we can just
shield
quickly run.
Sir, their aft shield is draining.
I don't want to waste my torpedoes at this range, though. Should have timed how long it took for us to get that initial distress call to them saying, oh, we're dead. Let's see if that does it. Yeah.
Hull integrity at 50%.
Come on, fire. I'm kind of afraid if I leave now, the game might go, well, hang on a second. But I'm pretty sure the station can hold itself against one Galor. Then again, the Galor might just simply follow me. So let's go to... What was it?
Course laid in.
And what?
Captain, we can't leave.
Fuck.
Now that we've led the enemy to the starbase, we have to stay and defend it.
Okay, this might be a problem then.
We have collapsed their bottom shield.
Good. Can we just swing around quickly? Seems to be dead in the water. Right, go, go, go.
At 25%.
Captain, we can't leave.
Yes, you can.
Led the enemy to the
starbase.
Yes, we have to.
There we go.
Starbase is hailing us.
No time for that. We're off, mate.
I'm glad we could be of assistance, Captain. Next time, though, try to keep the enemies off our doorstep.
Hey, I needed you. You helped, but unfortunately we didn't have time to, resupply. Let's see how bad things are here.
On screen. Sir, we're going to hit.
Ah! Captain, are you a sight for sore eyes? We appear to have gotten ourselves into a right pickle. They've knocked out our warp engines. Would you kindly help me properly exterminate these pests?
Only if you exterminate that terrible accent.
Their top shield has failed.
That might have been a waste. Yeah. I'm not convinced those are going to hit. How are we doing power?
Power is at 50%.
Yeah, I figure let's bring our engines down. think we can afford to bring our shields down for now as well. Oh, are you kidding me? Alright. Is Geronimo...
75%. The RAF shield has failed, Captain.
Okay, well... As long as you're shooting at me, you're not shooting at the Geronimo, which we need to save.
Our ventral shields are draining, sir.
Okay, one of the gallows is down. Good.
Ah, you call that fighting? I'll show you a bloody fight. Full impulse.
Sir, we are draining your top shield. Sir.
We need to roll around. I think we're getting some hull damage there. Full impulse, fire torpedoes. Nice. All right. All fire on the cassock. I'll take its beams down. This should now be fairly easy, I think. Between the Geronimo and ourselves, we've got enough firepower here to easily take this thing down. Although that might hurt. That might hurt. Okay. All right.
Shields are draining, sir.
Minor damage. And he's cloaked. Okay, some sensor power, perhaps. Okay, I'll bring it back down. Main power is at 22%, or main battery is, anyway. Oh, we need to roll. Their weapons definitely penetrate shields. Hit by 6 quantums in one go, and yet their shields are still pretty strong. I wonder if again if it's just dorsal ventral shields are really the...
On screen! Captain, my warp drive is back online. I'm ready to go when you are.
Captain McRae is hailing us. On screen.
Captain, we can't take much more of this. Integrity is...
Oh my god. Did you really just use that line with that fake accent? Oh.
75%.
Okay, whatever. Okay, we need to really not present our port shields or ventral shields to them. Come on.
We have collapsed their bottom shield.
Geronimo. We can do this. Okay, hitting their weapon.
Shield is draining, Captain.
Starting to do some damage. This thing's definitely a bit tanky though, isn't it? I'm wondering if I'm making a mistake.
Main power is fluctuating, Captain. We'll have to reduce power to some systems.
Well, now we just have to wait till he decloaks. Let's come about to where we think he might be. Is there a shimmer? Okay, his ventral shields are badly damaged, that's for sure. Oh, nice. Well, his cloak's down now. He's also lost power, perhaps? No, he's going up, so. Well, let's take advantage. Nice.
Main power.
This guy is cooked, as they say these days. Rather a fire at your belly. That's the weak spot right now. take that.
Come on, roll. That's it.
Sir, we are draining their top shield.
Not really much to say at the moment. We're just slowly bringing this thing down. Not, you know, I don't have to, but I want to. I'm in no real danger, I don't think. I'm just a little bit worried about timers. Oh, that was a nice pretty shot, actually. That was a pretty shot. Okay, yeah, the Sovereign is pretty at certain angles, okay.
Auxiliary power is at 50%.
I still love the galaxy more.
Their forward shield is draining.
Our ventral shields are draining, sir.
Come on, you must be near death. Oh, we're out of torpedoes. We're out of torpedoes. Can we just kill it with phasers? Come on. Oh, the speed of these ships sometimes. I really do hope the mods make the combat a lot more interesting and fun.
Target's hull has been breached, Captain.
That's gonna hurt, isn't it? Oh, fuck. Oh, fuck, fuck, fuck. Okay, you know what? Bye.
Course laid in. Aye, aye.
I'm just lucky that didn't take out my warp engines. Fuck me.
Red ship alert. Is following us.
Docking sequence.
Yeah, no. Get in there and get repaired before that thing kills me. I mean, at least it's already like near death. Get a restock of quantums as well.
Welcome back.
Hopefully the Geronimo is a bit in a better shape as well now. And I did take out some of its beam weapons. Let's see, hopefully we're back at full strength now.
Red alert, shields up.
Yeah, that's better. Sir, how's Geronimo? Oh yeah, Geronimo's got nice strong shields. This guy's nearly dead. This is fine. We're going to have this no problem. Oh, did he just zip somewhere? Look, he moved forward very quickly. All right. Full power engines. Photons are fine for now. Don't mind wasting a few of them.
Target hull integrity at 20%.
You've no chance. Stand down.
Severely damaged, sir.
What? The behavior of that torpedo is so weird. It's like it's barely moving, but it's gonna hit you no matter what.
So much for our pursuer.
Silly Cardassians.
Cancel red alert.
Captain McCrae is hailing us. On screen.
Impeccable work, Captain. You really pulled my arse out of
loading
the fire.
Loading quantum torpedoes,
sir. My compliments
sir.
To your fine crew. It takes a lot to get the upper hand on old Gregory McCrae.
About three ships?
Aye, Commander. But I gave him hell all the same. No use dying foolishly. I'd prefer heroically, given the choice.
And much, much older.
I'll drink to that. Well, Captain, in light of your saving my buttocks, what do you say to my joining you? We've been ordered to join your task force to clear a path to the Alioth system. My warp drive is back online now. So lead on, good Captain. We're with you till the end.
Perhaps we should head back to Starbase 12 to rearm. The Geronimo could use some repairs as well.
Well, it just so happens we're already at Starbase 12. Isn't that handy? So let's just do that one more time.
Sequence initiated.
I said earlier that was a poor Scottish accent. I'm wrong. Obviously, that's an Irish accent more than Scottish. But when he said, "I kind of take it anymore," that sounded more like he was going for the Scottish approach, as if Scotty's infamous line saying that is also infamous in universe. I guess I don't know. Is it a meme within the Star Trek universe as much as it is outside of the Star Trek universe? Right. Well, I'll let the Geronimo take care of itself. We can now get on with our job. Let's go to... Ooh, that's the base thing, isn't it? So let's go to Poseidon.
Aye.
So we've already had an eventful mission. Three Galors down. A Kessock and a couple more Galors, I think. Save the Geronimo.
I'm not reading any defenders.
Why would they leave the sensor post undefended?
This could be a trap.
Or excellent timing.
Message from the Geronimo. On screen.
Looks like...
Red alert, shields up.
Shall I attack the sensor post?
Well, I'd answer you, but...
I'm detecting several objects decloaking.
I'd have no idea how to actually contact you. I mean, I guess I could...
Captain, multiple torpedoes inbound.
Wait, why?
Kessock signature.
I suggest evasive maneuvers, sir.
Sir, more torpedoes.
I'm guessing there are more of those cloaked torpedo launchers out there. Several more.
Can we detect them before they fire, Miguel?
Not likely, Commander. I recommend we finish our business here and leave.
Okay, I'm a little confused, but...
Captain, their attacks are draining our starboard shield.
Target hull integrity at 20%.
I'm a little concerned that Geronimo is not... I mean, can I hail?
Sir, more torpedoes!
Oh, there is! There is wingman commands!
Torpedoes incoming!
Sending orders. Orders acknowledged, sir. Transmitting your new orders, Captain.
Wait, okay.
Sir. Sending orders.
Okay.
Orders acknowledged.
Isn't that lovely? Just finding out this new, new concept. Mid-game. Oh my goodness me.
Save integrity at 75%.
Well, I'm dead, aren't I? How can I possibly live now? I mean... Brilliant. Well, I suppose that means I have to do all of that shit again. Great. Be right back. Okay, I'm back, and it's a very short break. I haven't actually done anything yet. I've just decided to go to the first planet in the list.
There's a sensor post ahead. I'm picking up a Galore and a Keldon.
Okay. I'm going to engage the ships first this time.
Red alert, shields up.
Let's see if we can do this. I am going to pop these up, though. Throw some photons at you, and then go quantums.
Captain, we have collapsed their bottom shield.
Good. That's good. But that's the dorsal shield I'm firing at now. Almost said ventral. Show me your belly. That's got to have hurt. There we go. You're gonna
has failed.
Go down. Just like all the others. just like me a moment ago.
Our starboard shield.
Okay, we need to roll around. Our dorsal shields are taking a beating.
Sir, they are draining our dorsal shield.
Waiting for it to present its belly or its top side. Good. This is some intense point-blank range combat right here. Super intense. Nice.
Their top shield has failed.
Trying to avoid 50%. Having its torpedoes fire at me. I can just stay above it like this. I feel like this is the first time I'm actually managing to maneuver around these ships much better than I used to. Probably because I've been playing the game a lot more consistently lately. I don't feel like I'm relearning the game each time, even though I probably still suck, but you know, whatever. I'll take it. Using my mouse wheel to control the speed is actually quite nice. Don't really have to think about it too much.
Their top shield has failed.
Turn my tractor beam off. Go. Yeah, the tractor beam definitely prevents them from turning too quickly, I think.
I'm picking up a Federation distress call on all frequencies.
Target hull integrity at 25%.
All Starfleet vessels, we've been ambushed in the Zion Trades system and need immediate assistance. Our ship is meeting heavy resistance.
Target hull integrity at 20%.
Ships. Please assist.
Alright, first I'll take this Galor down, and then what I'll do, we'll go straight and help the Geronimo, since it's maybe at better health. Right, let's set course for...
Course laid in.
And
the last of the Cardassian ships has been destroyed.
We can come back to this, it's not a problem.
McRae is hailing us. On screen. Captain, we're on a collision course.
Captain, are you a sight for sore eyes? We appear to have gotten ourselves into a right pickle. They've knocked out our warp engines. Would you kindly help me properly exterminate these pests?
By all means.
Shields are at 75%.
Their top shield has failed.
Oh, there goes my Discord again. Sorry.
Captain, their attacks are draining our starboard shield.
Captain, we have collapsed their bottom shield.
Starting to take damage. Ventral shields are not well.
Captain, their shield system has been disabled.
Oh, really? Well, you're fucked then.
Their shield system has been disabled.
Ah, you call that fighting? I'll show you bloody foot. Full impulse.
Captain, their attacks are draining our starboard shield.
Looks like the ventral shields is what I really need to hit. Maybe we can't, don't need to run away from this guy this time.
Auxiliary power is at 50%.
Mm-hmm. Come on, show your belly. That's it.
At 75%.
Main power is fluctuating, Captain. We'll have to reduce power to some systems.
Nice. That was very well done, if I do say so myself.
These alien ships are troublesome little buggers, aren't they?
Oh, please shut up. You're at full health now. Yeah, you're fine. So I guess the game then does at least... sensors. Hey! Is that minimized the whole fucking time I've been playing this game? Well, goes to show that I just don't pay attention to many things. It's a weird display.
Are at 75%.
Their top shield has failed.
Right, now that at least I know that there's a wingman, and I should have learned this already, but... Yeah. Let's see how well the AI actually does take advantage of it. Alright.
Cancel red alert.
The last enemy vessel has been destroyed. No other contacts on sensors.
Captain McCrae is hailing us. On screen.
Impeccable work, Captain. You really pulled my arse out of the fire. My compliments to your fine crew. It takes a lot to get the upper hand on old Gregory McCrae.
About 3 ships?
Aye, Commander. But I gave him hell all the same. No use dying foolishly. I prefer heroically, given the choice.
And much, much older.
I'll drink to that. Well, Captain, in light of your saving my buttocks, what do you say to my joining you? We've been ordered to join your task force to clear a path to the Alioth system. My warp drive is back online now. So lead on, good Captain. We're with you till the end.
He's an annoying character. Whatever. Let's go back to Starbase 12. Rearm. Repair. Yes. Re-energize. And see if we can order the Geronimo to do the same. Alright, can we... There it is. Hail Geronimo. Dock with Starbase.
New orders, Captain.
What do you know?
Acknowledge the command.
Okay. Should have done that last time. Well, at least now we can do it. How much easier would some of these previous missions have been if I'd known or bothered to check some of these little nuances? Hey. Maybe you're entertained by my ignorance. I don't know. It's actually nice having the Akira model come in and out. If there's one thing that's kind of annoying me about this game is that we're not really flying anything else. We flew the galaxy for what? 3 or 4 missions, and then we're just stuck in the Sovereign for the entire game, and I want to fly other things. Even Starfleet Command had more than this. Dock, please.
Docking sequence initiated.
What do we have? We had the Oberth, the Miranda, the Constitution, and the Excelsior. That's 4 things we could have flown. In this, we have 2. I'm just talking about the main campaign, that is. At points where you fly a different ship for whatever reason or another.
Hello, Captain.
So, technically, Bridge Commander wins because it has 5, whereas Starfleet Academy had 4. Klingon Academy still wins by a mile. Because it had, like, I don't know, 12, at least. Right, because what do you have? You had the Oberth, you had those little frigate Akulakas class, destroyers, then you had the Mirandas, and you had the Constitution, you had the Excelsiors, then you had the Excaliburs, then you had those 2 battleship classes as well. Oh, there's my Steam going off now as well. I'm just annoying all of you with my notifications right now. And it seems I have to step out for a moment, so I'm going to pause this video for a momentarily. Paused. And I'm back. I had to take the dog for a walk. It's nighttime walk. So, what are we doing? We are repaired, rearmed. Okay, let's go to the next planet. Oh yeah, we need to kill this soft, don't we?
Aye, aye.
Let's go finish this off. Right, let's kill the sensor post.
Red alert, shields up.
I'm going to use photon changing torpedoes on this. Load. Oh, no, not phase torpedoes.
To photon torpedoes, Captain.
Will the Geronimo also fire on its own, or...? Let's put our shields down, because we don't need our shields right now. Yep, that helps very nicely, thank you.
Target hull integrity at 75%.
Yeah, it looks like quantum torpedoes basically just do a straight up 2x the damage. You know, one thing that's always annoyed me is the inconsistency of torpedo damage. I mean, these things are basically nuclear warheads in terms of what they're... I mean, it's literal... better than nuclear warheads even, because it's a literal antimatter bomb. It's a 100% efficient energy exchange, or release, rather. At least that's my understanding of matter-antimatter explosions. They annihilate each other, right? So
red alert.
I love how that's just sitting there. That's brilliant. So yeah, these things should basically annihilate or flatten even an entire planet very easily. Early seasons of TNG were actually fairly good in, like, you know, if we launch torpedoes with our shields down, we're going to be blown up, indicating the sheer power of them. And there's a couple of instances where the characters just didn't even blink. You know, they destroyed a Romulan warbird with a single torpedo. Granted, it was a fake warbird, but... let's go to Ceres with those three gallows.
Course laid in.
But...
Yes, Captain.
Torpedo power. Not very consistent. It should be... You know.
Captain, I'm reading 3 Galore class vessels circling the sensor station.
Yes,
message
as usual.
Message from the Geronimo. On screen.
We're right with you, Sovereign.
Red alert, shields up.
They're not moving. But so early TNG, the torpedoes were there, and it was treated like a very dangerous weapon. And then subsequently, it's just like, it's like a regular non-nuclear torpedo in terms of its damage. I mean, even with shields down. But then, you know, even in the older series, it was inconsistent, like in Star Trek 3. The Enterprise fires 2 torpedoes at an unshielded bird of prey as it's decloaking, which basically only causes minor damage, when it should have in fact annihilated it, given the power of those torpedoes. Now, you could argue maybe it's the hull, they're resistant to that, but still. They made a weapon which is incredibly powerful, but its power is determined by the nature of the plot of the given episode. There's the Starfield going all weird again. I wonder if that's a pole thing, like in TFTC or X-Wing in general, X-Wing Alliance. Because we use 6 skyboxes, so basically in a cube formation to draw the skybox. Well, this is definitely going easier with the Geronimo helping us.
Ship is on a collision course with us.
That's a wasted torpedo. Because one of the gallows is already dead, and it's not us killing it.
Their bottom shield is draining, sir.
So power energy, like, okay, so we're kind of just running on normal power levels here. And we're comfortable, we're fine.
Target hull integrity at 50%. Sir, they have hull breaches on multiple decks.
Yes.
Their hull is severely damaged.
Come on.
good. Let's kill this last Galore.
Shield has failed, Captain.
Okay, between us both, you have zero chance. Except all his torpedoes missed. Love it.
Their top shield has failed. Target hull integrity at 20%.
Hopefully those will hit and taken down. There we go.
Their hull is severely damaged, sir.
Right, now to this thing.
The last Galore has been destroyed, Captain.
Captain McCrae is hailing us. On screen.
Engage in the sensor post now.
This thing should die quickly. So I'm thinking we'll head back to Starbase 12, rearm again. Do our stuff. Then we'll go to the second system, which I'm anticipating might be something that's actually empty, quiet, maybe. And then we'll do the one that's surrounded by torpedoes last, and we'll just try and basically ninja that one.
Target hull integrity at 50%.
Oh, my intensity is still on low. That's interesting. Alright.
Cancel red alert.
The sensor station has been destroyed, sir.
Okay, let's go back to Starbase 12 then, and warp. Dock.
Docking sequence initiated.
Now, what is annoying here, because this is an unskippable cutscene, is that when we order the Geronimo to dock, we'll get the same unskippable cutscene. I guess it's necessary to make the ship go from A to B and re-perform all the scripting necessary to set the ship basically back to its 100% stats. So that's probably why this is unskippable, because it has to be a sequence of events and scripts to perform the redock, reload nonsense. Dock with Starbase.
Transmitting your new orders, Captain. Orders acknowledged, sir.
I always feel like its saucer section is like a little too small on the Akira. Depends on the angle you're looking at. At certain angles, the Akira is really cool looking. I always thought the NX-01 Enterprise was like a upside-down Akira class when I first saw it, or at least inspired by the Akira class. So just flip it upside down, you see exactly what I mean. That could be a 24th century variant of an NX-01 class. Probably the reverse. Right, let us go then to set course for... Is that one? So Poseidon is the one with the torpedoes. Let's go to the Gebel system.
Yes, Captain.
And engage.
Captain, I'm picking up a sensor post and one other contact.
It has the same
red
energy
alert,
signature as the Kessok vessels we fought off at Starbase 12, and I can't detect any life signs aboard. But that's where the similarities end. It's an entirely different configuration.
Judging by its size, I'd say this is some kind of heavy assault cruiser.
We'll soon find out. The Kessok ship has detected us and is powering her weapons.
Captain McCrae is hailing us.
Dear.
On screen.
Whoa, that's a big ship. I'll set him up and you knock him down, Captain.
Yeah. Okay. Good thing we've got the Geronimo then, right? It's interesting watching this ship move in relation to how I'm moving. Let's see if we can use the tractor beam method. So we can simply just outmaneuver it. think we're going to have to go back to the starbase after this. So far, we're doing alright. That was a nice shot. That was a nice shot. We're alright. Just trying to see if I can knock its engines off, but of course its shields are probably ridiculously powerful. This is a massive ship though. Look at it in relation to the Sovereign. You know, we're the closer camera angle and we're still being dwarfed by this thing.
Their bottom shield.
Nice. Yes, that's what I like to see. Can we get a...
Target hull integrity at 75%.
Yeah, this is the size of a Romulan warbird, easily. Oh, it's lost the shields.
Their shield system has been disabled.
Oh, nice. Okay, well, you're dead then, aren't you? I think this ship is going to be basically very deadly in its forward firepower, but as long as you maneuver around it, you're basically going to be fine. I wonder if that also affects their power levels with the warp core being offline.
Target hull integrity at 20%.
Nice.
Cancel red alert. Yellow alert, shields up.
Alright.
Kessock ship has been destroyed, Captain.
Message from the
general. Cool.
On screen.
Yeah.
The bigger they are, the harder they fall. We're closing in on the sensor post now.
I like the sheer tonal difference in those two voice lines there. Yeah, I don't like this character. I feel like he's just a Irish caricature badly done. But then I'm not Irish, so I can't really say with any certainty. If any of you who are watching this, or what few of you are watching this, are Irish, then you can tell me and correct me, the silly Englishman.
Sensor post destroyed.
Cancel red alert.
Alright then, back to Starbase 12. Let's do the cheesing. I don't think I'm going to bother with the Geronimo this time. But what we'll do on this one is we'll just go straight for the sensor post and then get the fuck out of Dodge. Okay, dock.
Sequence initiated.
And then, hopefully, if that succeeds, that'll probably be the end of at least this mission. I'm not sure about this episode, but it will be the end of this particular video.
Hello, Sovereign.
All right, then. This should be... Oh no, there's two more things to do, isn't there? We've got to do the fucking supply base, haven't we? Jesus. Oh, this is a long one. It's going to be a long one. Let's see if we can do this in the next 10 minutes.
The sensor post is ahead. I'm not reading any defenders.
Red alert, shields up.
Why leave the sensor post undefended?
This could be a trap.
It is a trap.
Excellent timing.
Message from the Geronimo. On screen.
Looks like nobody's home. Shall I attack the sensor post?
Sir, I'm detecting several objects decloaking.
Transmitting your new orders, Captain. They have acknowledged the command.
Captain, multiple torpedoes inbound. They're positrons. Kessock signature.
I suggest evasive maneuvers, sir.
Another volley of torpedoes incoming.
I'm guessing there are more of those cloaked torpedo launchers out there.
Captain,
we detect them before they fire, Miguel.
Not likely. I recommend we finish our business here and leave.
Another volley of torpedoes incoming. Sir, more torpedoes.
Can I get away from this?
Target hull integrity at 50%.
That'd be funny if I can make this thing hit the torpedoes. Alright, go.
The sensor post has been destroyed.
I've reported our progress.
Sir, they are draining our dorsal shield.
She's responding.
Laid in.
On screen, Ensign.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Good work destroying the sensor posts. Now take out the resupply base so we can retrieve Commander Data. You out.
Well, that was tough. Not so much tough as like a close one. Hopefully the Geronimo got out. One more dock.
Docking sequence initiated.
I don't understand the behavior of those torpedoes though. The way they move is very deceptive. And they're so massive. Something complaint I have about the games, like for example the shield, it's sometimes difficult to see visually what shield arc is actually being hit.
Good to see you again, Sovereign.
Again, something I feel that Klingon Academy visualized better. How's the Geronimo? Yeah, you're fine. Alright then. Set course.
Course laid in.
We'll stay at red alert. Let's
yes,
go.
Sir.
Captain, I've located the resupply
saving
on long-range sensors. It's in.
Hang on a second. Okay, well.
Nacella 3.
I'll continue.
The Cardassian listening post's out of commission. It should be difficult, if not impossible, for them to detect our approach.
Is this where we left Data? I think it is.
Cancel red alert.
Okay, so I guess we'll just orbit the planet then.
Standard orbit. Aye, sir. Entering standard orbit.
Scan target, I guess.
Initiating scan. I'm not finding anything new, Captain.
Oh, fuck.
Your
what do
orders,
I do?
Captain? Let's take out that resupply base.
Yes, Captain?
Yes, Captain?
So where is the supply base? Am I missing something?
Course laid in.
I feel like I'm missing something here.
Captain?
Show mission log. It's in a cellar one. Okay, sorry. Right, that's what I missed. Right, okay. Silly Billy.
Course laid in. Aye, aye. Leaving orbit.
Captain, you can't warp around the planet. In orbit of a planet, it will destroy something. Nice glow.
Red alert, shields up.
Okay, I'm here.
Initiating scan. I'm not finding anything new, Captain.
What?
Initiating scan.
Yes, sir.
Oh, it's three. The text is so small.
I'm not finding anything
oh
new,
my
Captain.
God. That is embarrassing. Very embarrassing.
Laid in.
Hey, at least we scanned two planets. Yay. Wasting my time and yours. Right, there we go. Ooh, hello. Freighters and defenders.
Captain, I have the station on scanners.
Threat assessment, Lieutenant.
Three
Cancel
Cardassian
red
warships
alert.
And four freighters docked with the station. In their current state of readiness, I'd say we caught them by surprise.
The docked ships appear to be unpowered, Captain.
If we move fast, we might be able to take them out before they can bring their drive systems online.
Right.
Looks like we caught him with our pants down, Sovereign. We're moving in.
Can you get a reading on what's in those freighters, Miguel?
Negative, Commander. They seem to have some kind of dampening feel around
their
hull.
Sending orders.
Sensors are unable to penetrate.
If they go through that much trouble to hide it, then whatever they're carrying must
be important. Red alert, shields
up. Intercept course.
Maybe we could disable one of the freighters.
I want to disable the warships first before they're a problem.
The station is sending a narrow-beam subspace transmission. It looks like a distress call.
Ensign, try to jam their communications. The last thing we need are more Cardassian ships coming to the party.
Aye, Commander.
So you want us to disable one of the freighters, do you?
Sir, we're going to hit.
Okay, we're not being shot at yet, so I'll put shields lower.
The Galores are powering up their engines and weapons systems.
Target hull integrity at 25%. He's right. The Galores are coming online and the freighters are preparing to make a run for it.
Alright, let's disable one of the freighters. We need to disable warp engines, don't we?
That freighter's going nowhere now.
Sir, we're going to hit.
Their left shield is draining, Captain.
Just need to make sure your warp engines are down. Okay, one of the other Galores is down, so we basically knocked out two of them very quickly. Oh, whoa, 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 whoa. I just want to make sure those warp engines stay down. I'm using low intensity phases.
Freighters is decoupling from the station.
Right. You in the meantime. Did I just... Oh, I didn't.
Changing torpedo load.
Hell.
Photon torpedoes, Captain.
Our ventral shields are draining, sir.
It's alright.
We
disabled one of them. Can we scan them?
Captain, the station has raised shields and is powering up its weapon systems.
Sir, oh god.
One of the freighters is powering up.
Captain,
initiating
scanners
scan.
Registering new contacts entering the system.
They must be responding to the station's distress call.
We're in danger of colliding with another ship, Captain.
That was close.
Sir, their aft shield is draining.
Yeah, those disruptor blasts are point-blank range. Oh, they did a lot of damage.
Sir, they are draining our dorsal shield. Up. Captain, we have collapsed their bottom shield.
Alright, let's take these reinforcements down, then we'll take the station down.
Tractor beam has been disabled, Captain.
Sir, the right shield...
Shields are taking a beating. Oh, that's because our shields are also pretty shit right now, isn't it? Fuck me. That's what I did last time that killed me. Let's get out of range. Can we order the Geronimo? Yeah, you go after this guy, chasing me.
Sir, we are draining their top shield. The forward shield is draining.
Okay, let's come about. I think I may not win this. And if I can't abandon the Geronimo either. Much I'd like to.
Sir, their aft shield is draining.
Nice. Missed. Let's try and keep my starboard shields angled here. I'm firing low intensity again.
Danger of colliding with
getting off.
75%.
Get off my ventral shields.
Captain, we have collapsed their bottom shield.
Oh, that's a waste, isn't it? Can we warp away?
Shields are at 75%.
What if we...
Course laid in. Yes, Captain.
Oh, we can. Question is, will the Geronimo follow and will the ships follow? If the ships follow, we might be able to get away with this.
Cancel red alert.
Let's see if they follow. Oh, the Geronimo here. Okay. Let's deactivate all, at least minimal sensor power. All right. Damage assessment. Not good. Is there no way I can increase this? They are definitely increasing, aren't they?
I have nothing to add, Captain.
Well, that's fine. I'm surprised the Cardassians haven't actually followed us. Is this damaged power? I wonder. Is that just a result of the warp core? I'm guessing so. There's a corresponding gap here that may seem to line up with that. Let's put our efforts into the warp. Can we actually... Can we do this?
Course laid in.
We'll need to power our engines for that, Captain.
All right, yeah. I will laugh.
Aye, Captain.
Oh my god, we can do it. That's hilarious. Because presumably we can do just get the Geronimo to do this as well. This, oh my goodness me. I'm glad, in a way, the game lets you cheese this.
Welcome back.
Right, how is the Geronimo? I think you should also get a bit of a clean. At least the bad guys are going to wait for a few weeks while we, you know, fix everything up. Oh yeah, you need some help. So, you, hail, yes, down, dock.
Sending orders. They have acknowledged the command.
Now, hopefully when we arrive, it'll be at the same distance from that station. We can just engage the Cardassian ships at range, and then we can focus on the station. Destroyed the warp engines of one freighter, so we know we're all right there. We got that little side gig. Right, set course.
Course laid in. Yes, Captain.
Okay, and then it was number 3, wasn't it?
Course laid in.
Wait for the Geronimo to arrive, maybe? I don't want to bug it out. There it is.
Yes,
okay,
sir.
Off we go.
Captain, scanners detecting multiple contacts entering the area. Cardassian configuration.
So much for good timing. All hands to battle stations.
Captain,
well,
our attacks are draining their right shield.
They seem to be the exact same Cardassians
Cardassian warships
as last
Maybe
time.
Maybe wiser to go after the new arrivals than to finish off the supply outpost.
Well, that was the idea. Oh, more unknown ships.
Their top shield has...
That's fine. That's fine. I'm not gonna screw this up. Come on.
Target hull integrity at 50%.
Target
hull integrity at 20%.
That's annoying. I wonder if I keep going back to the station, does two more defenders just end up showing up?
Breached, Captain.
Hopefully the Geronimo can hold on. Nice.
It's draining, Captain.
Let's help finish off this other one.
We're in danger of colliding with another ship, Captain.
He's down, that's fine. So this is basically a repeat of the defenders that we already had, the destroyed. I guess it respawned them.
All Cardassian warships have been destroyed.
Oh, we make an excellent team, don't we, Sovereign? Now let's
Target
finish
integrity
off that station.
At 75%.
I think we're well out of range at the station. No, that station is actually firing.
The aft shield has failed, Captain.
Oh, that the first defender had it.
System has been disabled. Sir, they have hull breaches on multiple decks.
Yeah, we're taking them down nice and quick.
Their hull is severely damaged, sir.
Good. And then the last defender.
Their top shield has failed.
Nice. Now let's take down that station. Hail Geronimo.
Transmitting your new orders, Captain. They have acknowledged the command.
Intercept.
Power is at 50%.
Are you going to intercept?
Intercept course plotted.
There we go.
Captain, more Cardassian ships.
What? Well, I don't see them. Oh, there they are. Oh, bugger me.
Sending orders. They have acknowledged the command.
Okay, one of these buggers. Let's hit the impulse engine.
75%.
Because our power levels are not great either. Just want to try and avoid getting into the... Yeah, four beams. That's not nice. Get its shield generator again? That's what seemed to do us well last time. Need to get above it.
Sir, our aft shield is draining.
Captain, we have collapsed their bottom shield.
Come on. Running out of quantums now. I'm not too bothered about the station at this range. We just need to take this Kessok ship down. Can we hit the shield generator? Yes, shield's down.
At 75%.
Oh, whoa, that was a nice damage texture. The ship is glitching.
Target hull integrity at 25%.
Still alive. Bullcrap. There we go. Now you can attack the station. And hopefully no one else.
Pursuer.
Silly Cardassians.
The ship has been destroyed, Captain.
Message from the Geronimo. On screen.
Woo-hoo-hoo! The bigger they are, the harder they fall.
Yes, thank you. We've heard that. Reduce our power systems a little. Oh, they're attacking my targets as well, so they'll attack the disruptor cannons just like me. It's nice.
Is fluctuating, Captain. We'll have to reduce power to some systems.
Nice. The disruptors are what really hurts, so not too fussed about the actual compression beams.
Power is offline.
Yeah, we'll be fine. Oh, we're actually out of torpedoes. That's me being
torpedo load.
We'll take out at least your disruptor cannons.
Captain McCrae is hailing us. On screen.
Captain, we can't take much more of this. Integrity is down to 50%.
Oh. Phases then?
Shields are at 75%.
Oh god. I've launched the... Oh fuck.
Switching to photon torpedo.
Auxiliary power is at 50%.
Well, that certainly did it. That was an overkill, but I've just wasted three of my unwastable torpedoes, which is always fun. God damn it.
Our ventral shields are draining, sir.
Certainly having the Geronimo on this mission has helped a great deal. Would definitely have made this a lot harder if we did not have it. Can we have this one disruptor bank firing at me not fire at me anymore? There we go, all disruptor cannons offline. Let's take this one down as well, because it's getting a bit rearmed. I think we can concentrate on the power plant now. Let's drop shields down. There we go. Alright, I wonder if we actually end up fighting a full-sized Cardassian station like DS9 or another Terraconaut. I think the model's in the game. Oh no. Oh no.
All hands abandon ship! All hands
Oh, he did it twice as well.
The Geronimo has been destroyed.
Oh, brilliant. I guess we don't really need him anymore. My problem is maybe we'll need him for the next episode, so what I'll do is I'll try and complete this. And then I'll check to see if the Geronimo is actually kind of needed for the last episode. It's gonna take forever to kill this thing. I might speed this up just to speed things along, because this is boring and it's actually getting really late and I need to stop playing. Just sweep through the arcs. Yawn. More volley of torpedoes. I guess we go from the aft then. Let's go. We step the freighter.
My post has been destroyed, Captain.
I've reported our progress to Admiral Liu. She's responding. On screen,
sir, their aft shield is draining.
Excellent work, Captain. With the sensor stations and resupply outposts destroyed, our plans to retake the Alioth system can proceed. Return to Starbase 12 to rearm and prepare for the final phase. Liu out.
Can we scan this target while we're here?
Initiating scan. Scanning. They're carrying various Marshall supplies, including photon torpedoes, shield emitters, and disruptor batteries.
And here's their transport log. It indicates the weapons were to be delivered to Alioth.
It should cause them some inconvenience when these supplies don't arrive.
Okay. I think we're done.
Cancel red alert.
Let's go to Starbase 12 and end this.
Aye, Captain.
Alright, so yeah, we're on mission for episode 7. Okay, thank you very much for joining me. I really have to go, so I'm going to make this very brief, but yeah, I'm going to check on the Geronimo situation, because if it's going to be in episode 8, I might just redo this off screen, just so I can actually save the Geronimo. But yeah, that was quite a long, long mission, and this is going to be a long video, so I apologize for that. But anyway, until the next video, rather, leave your comments and do fly safe.